Good afternoon, YouTube. So this is the flexible hose off my shop vac. Actually, this is from the shop vac I had before came with this hose. The shop vac finally died, so I picked up a new unit, and it has a flexible hose, but I kept the hose off the old unit because it made a good extension. And this end is the end I would have the crevice tool attached to. And at some point, I forget when it happened, but this thing apparently cracked a couple of times. And I tried gluing it, and I also wrapped it in some aluminum duct tape to try to hold it together. And that's where I used to have this attached to. But you can see it is no longer attached, and I don't think I'm going to be able to glue anything back on there because this thing's just all in pieces. So what I did was I took some measurements here. This is about 54 millimeters, and this is about 57 millimeters. So I designed this in Fusion 360, 54 and 57 millimeters. It printed a little bit small, but the idea is I want to try to enlarge that. You can see there's a bit of a lip around here. I need to try to figure out how big to make this thing to fit inside, and then that'll fit here. Now the part printed a little bit undersized. I think when you print with this is in ABS, and I think as it prints it must shrink a little bit, so I'm reprinting this scaled up by 2%, which should expand it about 1 millimeter, and that might be just about enough here because I want to have it, not too tight a fit, but it's a little bit loose right now, so I figure I'll just keep bumping the size up until I get a nice tight fit. It's about 18 grams of filament, and it's a pretty strong part. So I printed it 1.8 millimeter wall thickness. Since I'm printing with a 0.6 millimeter nozzle, that's basically three layers, and this is 100% infill then. Okay, YouTube, there's version 2, printed out 2% oversized, so I scaled the X and Y 1.02 or 102%, and then what I did was just ran my Dremel drum sander around the inside to kind of clean up the ID to fit, and there we go. So I think I'm going to glue this in just so it's tight in there. And then the other thing I did was chuck this up in my lathe and just sanded this rough printed surface, sanded it down kind of smooth, and now that fits in there. Nice tight fit. So I figured it was easier to make this just a little bit bigger and then make that a little bit bigger to fit rather than trying to get the exact size to print out. I think it's just easier to print it a little bit bigger and then enlarge that hole a little bit. Okay, YouTube, next morning the glue's set up. I think that's in there just right, and now I've got a functioning shop vac hose again. So that was a pretty simple repair. Kind of sealed up some of the cracks in the corrugated hose there. So this is my old vacuum hose, and then this can couple it to the newer hose that's in better shape, but maybe get a few more years out of this thing. You can buy new ones, but I figure I have this old one and it still is functional, so quick little fix with the 3D printer. That's pretty neat when you can just make a custom part like that. And in about an hour, you have that. Find out it's not quite the right fit. Print another one another hour later, and you have a perfect fit. I'll put the link to this in the video description. If you have a similar kind of hose like this and need to repair it, that's a good way to go. Yeah, and so if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section down below. And as always, thanks for watching.